This is an example of solving batch reactor system that's isothermal. It's for most batch reactors. It's a liquid phase reaction. And this has two reactions, A reacting to B, B then subsequently reacting to C. Something that's slightly different from other systems is that the reaction from A to B is reversible and also fast in both directions. So essentially, we can look at the first reaction as an equilibrium, and then we have a rate constant for B reacting to C. So the ratio of A to B is going to be determined by equilibrium. We're given the equilibrium constant here, and we're given that initially we start out with only A in the reactor, and the concentration of A is 1.5 moles per liter. So we want to solve this problem by setting up a mass balance. And in this case, we're going to do a balance on C. Since A and B is in equilibrium, it makes the most sense in terms of ability to solve by writing a balance for C. First order is indicated by the units of the rate constant. Okay, so first order. And so one of the things to note is this is a positive sign because the reaction that we're looking at of B going to C forms C, so we expect the number of moles of C. Where N sub C is the number of moles of C in the reaction. Now, N sub C is the concentration of C times the volume, which means we can write this derivative as the volume times the concentration of C is equal to K concentration of B times the volume. Now, the reason we can write the reaction this way and bring the volume outside is because it's liquid phase, and so for liquid phase a reasonable assumption is constant density, which means the answer doesn't depend on the volume. Okay, and the answer is how does the concentration change with time for the product? That's what we're looking for. So what we want to do is solve now this mass balance. In this case, we could take advantage of stoichiometry and the equilibrium constants because 1 mole of B forms 1 mole of C, and 1 mole of A forms 1 mole of B. Then the concentration or the number of moles can be written as the sum of the individual concentrations, because the number of moles of A initially should equal to total number of moles, right? So this is based on the fact number of moles of A we start with should equal the number of moles we have at a later time because of the stoichiometry. And we can substitute in the concentration equation. So I'm going to do some rearranging. Ca0 minus concentration of C is going to be equal to the concentration of A is the concentration of B over 2.0 from equilibrium. And of course, plus concentration of B. So this is 1.5 times the concentration of B. Which means that we can now write the concentration of B as, let me rearrange 1.5, the concentration of B. So the concentration of B, which we want to be able to substitute in. So you'll notice now we have reaction mass balance for the reaction. That's in terms of concentration of B and C. This allows us to make the equation just in terms of the concentration of C and time. So we go back to the mass balance again. Change in the concentration of C respect to time is equal to the rate constant, which is 0.5, times the concentration of B, which is 1 minus 0.67, the concentration of C. So we have an equation that we can separate variables now and integrate, and we'll go through the simple integration. Okay. Now we integrate from a starting time to, we want to know the concentration of C at a later time. The initial concentration of C is zero, right? So this equation, the initial condition is the concentration of C is zero. We integrate the first term. So if we now do this integration as shown, and substituting in the limits, we have the log of 0.5 minus the concentration of C at a given time divided by 0.5 equals minus 0.33 times T. So this then we could plot to tell how the concentration of C changes with time.